the door I've been knocking on all along.
What?
There was nothing there.
You've been knocking on that for that
long? Yep, yeah, at the beginning. The woman was killed years ago. It's monsters who took over and was doing experiments on the bodies.
Really?
Yeah.
So, there was,
I've already killed the boss of these little pricks.
Wow.
Yeah. Last night.
How do I hear a baby?
Nauseous. Have you found this? It's progressing. I can see things.
A real person.
I knew it. I'm different.
Experiments.
Oh, God, it feels awful. But it proves that I'm chosen. Don't you see?
If your health is not high enough, you will find yourself dying once you get all the way up to the top here. So we're going to find the summons, and then we have to go to...
God, I'm nauseous. It's progressing. I knew it.
Completely different area of the game, so there's going to be a lot of tracking involved in this video. This is going to be a nice tour of the entire town here. Alright, once you're up here, go through this gate over here. The other gate actually takes you to the very beginning of the game, which we'll go to momentarily. And then we'll go up and climb here, and we're going to get to a roof with a bunch of crows on it. The crows are right in front of me, so I'm going to go to the left. There's another set of crows somewhere, but once you get inside this building, head right, and inside this room, and I've already grabbed it already, but it's going to be the location of the summons. Can't miss it, because it's going to have that little glowing thing on top of it. So now we got to go find a lantern, so we're going to go back the way we came, and we're actually going to go to the very first room that you start the game in, so you might recognize it, where you have to kill that werewolf, probably for the first time without any weapons before you realize you needed weapons. So we're going to go in here, take the lantern, go back to the Hunter's Dream. we'll slow this down here, put it in the regular motion here. What we need to do is go to the Hemwick Charnel Lane.
Was there another way in there? Do you see another way out? Was that it? That's it, isn't it?
Hemwick's
Eternal Lane. How the hell do I access that? So we need for the upgrade.
Very well, let me.
Oh my god, I'm so much unsure, that's crazy.
Need 86 more. Oh no!
No, it's 2886.
Welcome, what is it? Very well, let me.
Hemwick's.
Where the witch fight was located. It's going to be in a very large clearing prior to that area. So once you've made it here, hopefully with the summons in hand, we're going to go to the large clearing. If you've already unlocked this elevator here, the shortcut path, you can come up here. If not, you'll have to circle around to the left. There's going to be a few more enemies, but at this point you can just run past everyone. You're going to have to kill this person here, though. But everything else you're able to just run right past.
How the hell did he access that?
The elevator here, we're going to take the lift back up. And watch out for these guys here. There's some crows and that other dude. And we're very, very close to where we need to be. Once you enter this large area here, there's going to be a kind of a monument here up front in the center. All you need to do is approach it.
See, how would you figure this out?
People must have took, it must have took ages for people to figure this crap out.
And once you approach it, it's going to trigger a what I thought was a very unnecessary cutscene, so you can skip it if you like.
Oh,
I just hit the skip button. You can immediately go into the carriage here because there are still enemies in that area.
Fuck me, man.
Now that you've gotten into this carriage is going to take you to the hotel, or castle rather. I guess you can turn it into a hotel if you like. But once this cutscene is over, you will pop the trophy. Now inside of this castle is going to be another boss. Another boss that's tied to yet another trophy. And I will definitely show you that boss fight in a separate video. But I really do appreciate you guys watching this one. And if you found it at all helpful, please hit the like button. It helps me out. As well as leave a comment.
Should be interesting, shouldn't it? That's not spooky at all.
Should we get ready for that boss?
What do you mean?
Prepare for the boss?
No, investigate the area first. Always investigate, because we haven't got much stuff on us, so I'm not bothered if I lose it. So I can ready for bosses, you start gathering material, you start gathering stuff. Spider.
Spiders with legs and snakes.
That's gonna be a shortcut.
They're
come on, I should be able to beat this thing. Let's just get used to it. Where was that spider? Who was it killed? Oh, I never took my stuff. See me from here. $2,500 for one of them. Come back. Are they gone? Get up here. Crazy face. Buddy. I can get to it. Even tame around. Did he?
Oh,
What are they doing down there? You can't see anything down there, can you? I mean, there might be a cave there to the right. Look here. I don't know, something's telling me there's something down there. Go! I'm dead. Bridge. Doesn't matter, it's not tough, they are. Yeah, we'll throw it.
So slow.
Thank you.
Look how slow you are. Spiders. Cogwheels. Oh my God. Let me go. Someone's telling me to drop down there. Going. Scotty. I think I might drop down there now, do you reckon?
Yeah, I'm glad.
What if I die?
Oh no, don't do that.
That's too high. That's too high? Yeah, click, you know, remember what this place is called?
Sorry, the castle.
Click on your phone, Kane's Castle walkthrough, and it'll get up and then get fast forward to this part and see whether there's anything down there.
On my phone?
Yeah, on your phone. Got it. Right, I'll do now. Let's go see what's forward. You check if there's any, if it's worth dropping down there.
What's
Kane's Castle? Kane's
Castle
walkthrough. Bloodborne. Loads of new clothes. Why are you watching the fight?
I just put it on, man.
We don't want the fight, we want the walkthrough. Where is the fight? What room? Get the walkthrough up. Let's check this new gear out. Thank you.
What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the Expert Walk for Bloodborne. I'm your host, Leslie Darksels HD, and today we're going to continue the adventure to Kanehurst, which is located at the third tombstone right here. So before we actually go back, let's take a look at my inventory real quick and just see what I have on hand, make sure that I don't want to buy anything. So we have a good amount of pulling items. We've got gold paper, which is nice. I know that the enemies in Kanehurst are much weaker to fire than they are bolt, if I remember correctly. Now this is something new. This is something that we unlocked with the badge that we got from the guy in Old Yharnam. The Molotov that's on the rope explodes behind you. Everything else looks fine, I think. Yeah, I don't believe there's anything else that I need. Man, fire paper is expensive. I'd rather just buy it with insight. But I think we're only going to need one. I may as well start using up my bolt paper. So the first set of enemies at Kanehurst, those spider-legged, long-haired, freaky, flailing tongue, blood-pregnant things, you don't have to fight those every time you run past the first area. You saw how difficult they were stomping me in the last video. But there's really no easy way to deal with these things. I mean, they're... I would compare them to... Let's see. Probably the undead dragon pelvises from Dark Souls 1 down in Lost Isolith. There's no easy way to fight them. They have a lot of health and they hit very hard and you just... would much rather avoid them, but they leash right here. They're never going to follow you inside, so you don't have to fight them every time. Now, this room is interesting. There are ghost women in here that are invisible. Now, as soon as you fight these things, and for some reason they're trying to clean the floor with old, dirty rags, and you can hear them, like, just going insane, talking to themselves. Really isn't that bad. That's actually superb. It's a good thing we've been deaf because it's out of bounds. And if they do the scream, will slow you down and do damage, and he's supposed to come down. That was kind of strange. Just for anything, but you know, they can get you killed. It is an animal. Definitely designed to get you while you're not looking. I know what you're thinking, right? Well, a secret area. I could drop down there. No. You could drop down there and survive if it were an actual area. If you drop down right there, it's an instant death because it's out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
And if you look down from here, you can actually see that that's where we started. There's the bridge that leads all the way back over here. There's him with Charnel Lane. That is the roof complex that we were standing on when we looked over here from the lake.
Get me a new cloak.
Oh, that's much better. That's what I saw there.
Okay. Now again, statues and stuff. Make sure you watch out for the gargoyles. They are rather obvious. Still. This over here is a knight of Kanehurst, and they have the Rider Palash, which means they can shoot you, and they can stab really fast for a lot of damage. They're not difficult to overpower, obviously. But don't let your guard down. You look out here and you can see the rooftops and you can see back towards Eternal Rain. You can see the coast.
Fuck a move! Is this the boss room? I just feel like it is.
That's something that I mention in pretty much every playthrough that I do, is how you can look back and see the progress that you've made.
The next boss is very big, by the way.
What?
The next boss is very big.
Okay, we got a flag right here. That's interesting. I guess that's like the signal of Kanehurst. Two lions with dragon tongues. Or snake tongues, rather.
Dude, it's going to him.
Gargoyles. You can see the two ahead, but you never know when that's going to be a distraction. you can see access to another area that we're going to be at over there. Now this... Okay, let's grab this chest real quick.
Hold on, what the fuck?
This right in the beginning of the level. You don't want to make it that far just to have to run back again.
How did he access that?
You will too if you're smart. But you're going to hit a point where it gets a little confusing, and you may not know how to progress. More ghost women.
Okay. This is the part of the level that becomes a problem. This is where Kanehurst peaks in difficulty. See that thing up there holding the candle? It will shoot darts that poison you. And it'll also shoot something that causes these things to target you. It basically, like... It's kind of like somebody shooting a dart that has, like, a red cape on it when you're in a room full of bulls. That's essentially what this thing does. You get hit with a dart that targets you, and it'll cause them to go insane, and they will come after you with everything they've got. Now I'm going to go over here first. And you will too if you're smart. This is the shortcut. We covered this right in the beginning of the level. I know it's here somewhere. There it is.